direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop, it's HCTV News.
Hi, I'm Savannah LeBron.
And I'm Paul Caraballo. Welcome back to HCTV News.
It's great to be back, and we have plenty of news stories for you.
As we know, there have been new teachers coming and going over the past few years. Let's take a look at some of the new faces here at Cheney Tech.
Hey guys, last time on Faculty News, we introduced two new teachers, Ms. Jane and Ms. Wright. Now this time we're introducing two more teachers, Mr. Hill and Mr. Tomaselli. They both share a passion for teaching, and this is what they had to say.
I'd like to be able to impart knowledge to students and to be able to see their lives transform before me, especially in media production, where it's a field content that I really enjoy, and to see them get excited about it, it thrills me to be a part of their education.
Well, why do I like to teach? I like to be a teacher for a couple simple reasons. I am just blessed that I have the greatest job in the history of the world. I get to come into a school, hang out with adolescents, a bunch of high school kids, and help them hopefully find out what's going on in the world, in U.S. history. It's just, I'm so lucky. When you don't have to work every day of your life, when you have a job you love, it's a joy to come in.
The reason why I got into teaching is through films like Dead Poets Society and Man Without a Face and movies like that were really inspirational. I really wanted to get into the classroom, and I went to college for teaching, taught in the public school for 1 year, and in that year I had a desire to get into media production too. So I ventured off, took a break from the classroom, and got into media production. And I was able to get a position at the Public Access Studio North Windham, where I taught community members, high school students, college students, how to make their own television show. And I spent the 7 years at the studio producing shows, helping people produce shows. And just in this past year, I wanted to get back into the classroom and saw that there was an opportunity to actually teach media production in the classroom, and applied for it. And that's how I am here. That's where I am today.
Well, it's a family business. So my mom's a teacher, my aunts are teachers, my uncles are teachers. So, looking around, I'd had a few careers before I became a teacher. I entered the professional late in life, later than most, and just found out that I wanted to give something back, I guess. It's the best way to look at it. And I still remember the first day I walked into a middle school and started subbing, and I just, from that point on, I was going to be a teacher. I had to go back to school, finish up some coursework that I never had gotten in my bachelor's degree, and then did student teaching, did all that, and luckily was hired in the technical high school system, and where I am still today.
So when you see them in the hallways, make sure you say hello to them. Signing off for HCTV News, I am Jamie Vivar.
We would like to welcome our new teachers to the school.
We wish them a great teaching career here in the coming years.
What's the best part about being a senior here at school?
Senior release.
Yes, it is what every senior looks forward to every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday during the academics. Let's see what Will has to say about senior release.
A privilege for Cheney Tech seniors is early release. During early release, seniors are allowed to leave right after sixth period. We talked to Shavane Pearson and Aslam Kalaya on what they like about senior release and how they earned it.
What I like about senior release is that we get to leave school. We don't have to be here for a whole extra hour just doing nothing in our study halls. As seniors, I think that it's a good thing that we have senior release.
What I like about senior release is that we get more freedom. Like, we earned it, so we get to leave study hall because, I mean, we don't really do a lot in study hall anyways, but we get more responsibilities. Now we're seniors. That's what I like.
As a senior, we have to maintain good grades. We have to not be late for school, positive attitude in school. We have to make sure we're passing shop in order to maintain our senior release.
You have to keep up your grades. Your teacher, you can't drop below a C. You can't have any disciplinary records if you want to maintain senior release.
We also talked to electrical senior Sheldon Shelton, who does not have senior release. We talked to him why he didn't get it.
I don't have senior release because I failed CAP sophomore year, and when I retook it junior year, I failed it again for science. In order to earn my senior release back, I have to keep my grade above a 70 for science and my other grades as well.
Well, that is how you keep and earn your senior release. For HCTV News, I'm William Eastham, and I am going on my senior release.
Thank you, Will.
Ah, it feels good to be a senior.
Yes, it does. But with being a senior comes opportunity. What are some of the opportunities, you may ask?
Welcome back, students, to another great year at Cheney Tech. This year, we will be creating a new segment called Kids with Careers. This segment will be about students and their experiences working in different fields. Each student experiences a different work environment, and we're trying to give you a feel. From fast food to a garage, our school has it all. Students can have jobs such as a job at the movie theater, fast food, retail, services, and grocery store jobs, or even jobs in your trade. There's so much you can do in this high school. So if you're interested in finding a job and you don't know what is right for you, look out for the new segment in an upcoming HCTV News. Maybe you will see yourself in the segment. This is Anthony LaPenna signing off for HCTV News.
Now we have Rayshawn Lee bringing you another episode of What Do You Think?
This time, we are going to take a look at being addicted to your cell phone.
I am very addicted to my cell phone and I am constantly on it.
Never stays on my hand.
No, I'm not really addicted to my phone. I just use my phone for music purposes for the most part because, like, no one hits me up, you know?
Oh, I'm totally addicted to my cell phone. And I use it, like, 24/7 all the time.
No, I'm not a fan of personalizing my phone and getting different cases for it because I just use my phone for music for the most part. When I first got it, I used to be into that, but now I don't. That's why my phone looks the way it looks now.
I don't care about getting different cases or personalizing it.
Yes, I get new cases every weekend online, so a lot. Yes. I like personalizing my phone and having different cases because it makes my phone look pretty.
That pretty much sums up our generation. Cell phones can be helpful and fun, but can be a serious distraction.
Kids nowadays, huh? Most of us are addicted to our cell phones, and we all know about Facebook and Twitter. But how many of us actually know about the belief statement?
I could have put it into numbers, but here's what it's all about.
The Cheney Tech Belief Statement has been around for many years now. Let's go and ask some students what they think about the Cheney Tech Belief Statement.
About the belief statement, I'm not sure.
Not really.
What belief statement?
The what? Sorry, hold on, the what?
The Cheney Tech Belief Statement was created in the 2007-2008 school year. It was a survey given to the students, the parents, faculty and administration. The resounding themes that kept coming up across all four groups was the essence of our belief statement and our core values. The purpose of the belief statement has to do with school climate. And school climate sets the tone. It has to do with having respecting all students, their individual needs, and working together.
Next time you'll walk in the Cheney Tech hallways, make sure to take pride in noticing the belief statement. Signing off from HCTV News, I'm Paul Caraballo.
The Cheney Tech Belief Statement. We, the Cheney Tech learning community, in order to form a more positive school climate, express our belief in the following core values: respect for others and self, community involvement, truthfulness, honesty, and integrity, teamwork and unity, cultural diversity and hard work, and agree to express these values daily to the best of our abilities.
Well, One person who's definitely familiar with the belief statement is our assistant principal, Miss White.
She was recently promoted to her new position as assistant principal. Let's learn a little bit more about her.
For the new school year, we have new students, new policies, new faculty members, as well as old staff members in new positions. We talked to our new assistant principal, Mrs. White, to see what plans she has in store for our students here at Cheney Tech.
I graduated with my bachelor's degree from Eastern Connecticut State University in Willimantic. Then I started to work full-time in teaching, but went back for my master's degree to Southern Connecticut State University. And then in the last couple years, I went for my advanced certificate in educational leadership at Sacred Heart University, which is in Fairfield, Connecticut. When I first went to college as a computer science major. And that was really before the days of the internet. And so you basically, when you did your programming, which is that's what computer science was then, was writing program, you sat in one room with big computers all day long. So I got sick of sitting in that one room with all the computers writing and having the software not run that I was trying to write. And I said, I need to do something differently. My roommate at the time was an education major, and I helped her do all her homework. So once I knew I wanted to change, I thought about nursing at first. And then I said, what am I doing? My roommate is an education major, and I know all her work that she does so far because I do a lot of it with her. So that was kind of a natural fit. The reason I went into the math side of it was because of the computer science background, so I already had quite a few math classes. It's interesting when you change jobs because what you might perceive them as from a different job, they're always a little different when you get into them. So I really love teaching. I like working with the students, but I also like working with the adults in the building a lot. So it was kind of the natural next step in my job life to go on to the next higher level and to try to make the school a better place to be. Ms. Jackson and I work really closely together. So we really want to get students on board to take initiatives and take responsibility for what they want Cheney Tech to be. We think we have a really great senior class this year, and we really hope that they will lead the way. And I hope that we've communicated that to them. So far, we've had a really good discipline year. Students have been acting appropriately, and I think a lot of that is because of the role models they're seeing from their mentors and the older students in the school year. So I hope that as we move through the year, those people will still continue to lead the younger students and that we will be able to help everybody to get a good education here at Cheney Tech.
As you can see, Mrs. White has spent quite some time with the technical high school system and feels the school year is off to a great start. Keep it up, guys. Signing off for HCTV News, I'm Anthony LaPena. Have a great day.
Thank you, Ms. White, for taking time out of your day to share with us.
We would like to congratulate you on your promotion and wish you the best of luck in your new position. Speaking of new additions, the Eco House is coming to a finish.
It has had all the finishing touches added these last few days. We were there to get a closer look and spoke with the students and teachers who worked on the house.
For some time now, Connecticut Technical High School System has incorporated a green approach into how we teach our construction trades. In fall 2012, these shops had a chance to have a more hands-on experience with a project called the Eco House. The Cheney Tech Eco House was built by the shops Carpentry, Electrical, and HVAC. Each of these shops had a huge contribution in making the Eco House.
In the making of the Eco House, we've done the rough framing, we've done siding, we've done insulation on the inside, the drywall. We've done the outside interior walls of the before the siding. We've also worked on the outside and the inside of the windows.
In the making of the Eco House, Electrical has put up track lights, outlets, we've put a meter in, we've run wire from the tunnel to the E-House and from the tunnel to the electrical room. We've done a lot of things. We've put up the solar panels. We've also connected the meter to the panel inside the e-house. So we've done a lot of things in the e-house.
In the making of the eco-house, I've helped create the sheet metal roof that's up there. I've helped install the manifolds that will be helping with the PEX tubing, and I will be installing the heating and cooling system for the e-house.
Besides the eco-house being beneficial to our environment, it was also a great learning experience for the students and faculty involved.
Working with the e-house was a great project for my students because what it did is it took all the skills that we learned in 10th grade, all the skills we learned in 9th grade and 11th grade, and we culminated them all together.
The benefits that my students received, besides the typical hands-on of the construction process, is the benefit of learning the latest technologies in energy conservation.
While working in the eco-house, I learned how to work with other people and be on a productive job site.
I learned that there's a lot of ways to keep your house eco-friendly. There's a lot of ways to save money doing so, and there's a lot of different materials you can use to do this.
I learned how to fabricate sheet metal roofs. I learned pretty much everything that we did here was a learning process for me.
The construction trades of Cheney Tech broke ground in September 2012. All three of the trades came together as one and used all the skills that they learned and began working on the future of the trades.
With the students actually in the e-house themselves, they're doing the basic piping, basic wiring, all the way up to the state-of-the-art controls.
We built from the ground up. We had to dig the hole. We put in the stone. We built the floor frame. We did the wall framing, the roof framing. We did the siding, the insulation, the drywall, and the trim around the windows. And the last thing is installing the floor.
We used all the components of building construction, and we even interfaced that with the existing school system, which is the commercial type of work where we installed the components and interfaced the two of them together.
Cheney Tech being the fifth completed eco-house in the state is a very great accomplishment for the residential, commercial, and industrial construction trades. Cheney Tech's eco-house provides today's students with the opportunity to participate in becoming tomorrow's workforce. This eco-friendly project was funded by the state's two energy funds, the Clean Energy Finance and Investment Authority and the Connecticut Energy Efficiency Fund.
Well, that's a great showcase for that our HVAC, electrical, and carpentry shop have been putting for quite some time.
We would like to congratulate the school as well as the shops that work endless hours on constructing our e-house. That's it for HCTV News. I'm Paul Caraballo, signing off.
And I'm Savannah LeBron.
Have a great day.
Bye.